Ben Ransom, I play rugby at London Irish.
Ben, it's fantastic to have you tonight. Why is this such an important cause to be supporting?
I think just giving support to Charlie Hodgson, really, a guy that I played with many times at Saracens before. Now he's sort of involved at London Irish. So I think just giving support to him personally and also to the Nordoff charity as a whole.
And obviously Charlie is such an icon of the sport, the longevity of his career, the records he's broken. What for you makes him such a great role model for younger players?
I think just learning how he sort of trains and prepares for game when I was at Saracens, in terms of the amount of practice he puts in, not only during training but after training. The way he helps out with the young guys when I was at Saracens, I think it's just a credit to him.
Of all the great sporting contests, what do you think is unique about the Six Nations?
Oh, I just think the atmospheres they build at stadiums like obviously like Twickenham and up at Murrayfield. I think there's just a special vibe when it comes to Six Nations that you don't really get in the domestic competitions. I think also the quality of rugby, I think it steps up as well when the Six Nations comes on. I think definitely when you compare England against the Northern Hemisphere side, they've definitely been a sort of step above in quality, and I think they're going to carry that into the Six Nations. Obviously Eddie will be pretty pleased with his contract extension today, so I think the lads will be on a high and they'll be looking to push for that third one.
I mean, talking about the North-South divide, do you think the results for Ireland and Scotland against New Zealand show that that gap is, if anything, non-existent now?
To an extent, yeah. I think it's showing that New Zealand of the past was sort of unbeatable, but I think now, as teams are starting to beat them, the gap is definitely closing and it's leaving room for, like you say, Ireland and Wales to sort of, and England to sort of kick on and try and get them off that number one spot.
Of course, talking about London Irish, looking to the future, what are the targets that you guys are setting for this year and beyond?
Well, obviously, we're not in a great position at the moment, bottom of the table, but we're obviously taking each game at a time and we need to step up as a squad, really, and make sure we get that next win. I think the next three Premiership games are going to be a real challenge and defining moment of the season, really, because if we need to win them, basically.
Obviously, you guys are having a tough season, but I think the fan enthusiasm, both for London Irish and for the Premiership in general, has never been at a better place. Why do you think there has been that explosion of enthusiasm for the sport in recent years?
Yeah, I think definitely at Irish, they've obviously got that history of doing well in competitions. And I definitely think that that is sort of carried on to the domestic season at the moment. And we can definitely feel it when you're playing at home at the Majeski. Obviously, we're trying to move back to London, which I think will be better for the club. And hopefully the fan base will improve if we do move back. But I think it's just the general enthusiasm around the game at the moment.
My name's Theo Brophy-Clews. I'm a rugby player for London Irish Rugby Club.
It's fantastic to have you here tonight. Why is it so important to support this cause and to honour an icon like Charlie?
I think music therapy is a cause that's overlooked, really, and I think it's really like can be really helpful. I think music means a lot of things to a lot of people, especially who are in need. So it's amazing to be here tonight, and then Charlie as well. I've only met him recently, but he's an amazing man. He's a legend of the game, so I'm really excited to hear some good stories about him. Have a good time tonight.
And obviously, it's a tough season at the moment for London Irish. The next three games, I think, really feel like they're going to be crucially. Are you energised? Is the team geared up to get the results it needs?
Definitely, you're right. It's a big three games in the Aviva Prem, so we had a good result against the Russian team Krasnoyar the other night, so that's really good. So we need to build momentum going forward, so that's the main thing over the two next LV games as well, to build some good momentum going into the Premiership games.
Why do you think this season there has been that difficulty in replicating the European form in the domestic Premiership?
I think obviously last year coming from the Championship, we get used to a certain standard of rugby. Obviously we're trying to pride ourselves on being better than the competition last year. But the game evolves so quickly and having a year out of the Premiership makes it hard to adjust. So we're constantly trying to adjust things in our game and I feel we are getting there. But it's a slow process and hopefully it comes through the end of the season.
How excited are you about the approaching Six Nations? Obviously a wonderful spectacle for a rugby fan.
Oh, it's brilliant. I mean, having people at the club who are going to be maybe involved in it and just the whole like the hype up of it and everything is brilliant to watch, and England are always going to be amazing, so I'm really looking forward to see how the boys get on.